Hello students, today our topic is that is vectors. In this video we will discuss about some terms used for this chapter vectors. Now you can see here is axis, x axis, y axis and z axis. In vectors you can say I cap with x axis, j cap with y axis and k cap with z axis. Like you know, x axis, y axis and z axis are perpendicular to each other. Here I cap, j cap and k cap represent your x, y and z axis are mutually perpendicular as well as unit vectors. Unit vectors represented by cap, any vector represented by cap are called unit vectors. A vector having magnitude 1. Okay. If we have two points, initial point and final point, we can get a vector by final minus initial. Subtract x from x, y from y and z from z. With I cap, j cap and k cap, it becomes a vector. These scalar components of a vector, scalar components of vector are known as a direction ratio of that vector, represented by a proper symbol, that is small a, small b and small c. Without I, without j, without k, they are called scalar component of a vector. With I cap, with j cap and with k cap, they are called vector component of a vector. Now if we have a vector, let us suppose that we have vector a is equal to a1 I cap plus a2 j cap plus a3 k cap. You can get magnitude of a vector represented by symbol modulus, that is addition of scalar component of a vector, addition of space of scalar component of a vector and its whole square root is called your magnitude of a vector. After that unit vector, a vector having magnitude 1. How can we get a unit vector? A unit vector represented by cap. How can you get vector upon its magnitude? Vector upon its magnitude is called unit vector. In a unit vector, scalar component are known as direction cosines of the vector. Direction cosines of a vector represented by small l, small m and small n. These are scalar components of the unit vector. L, m and n. L like direction cosines. L cos alpha, m cos beta and n cos gamma. What are these alpha, beta and gamma? Alpha, beta, gamma are angles made with the coordinate axis, that is x axis, y axis and z axis respectively. Property of these direction cosines, L square plus M square plus M square, or you can say cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma will be always equal to 1. Here is a law, that is triangle law of addition. In a triangle, three sides are there, and two sides will be in the same direction and its resultant will be in their opposite direction, like AB vector following BC vector, but AC vector will be in its opposite direction. That is resultant of both sides, AB vector plus BC vector is equal to AC vector. These are the some terms used will be in your vector. Okay, thank you.